in the crowd, so I just wanted to give a little background about the group. But first up, I wanted to say thank you to Thomas and Tony and Gary. And they always do a great job serving us breakfast, so I just want to say thanks. So just to give you a little background about our group, we started in June of 2014 based on four main concepts. So we meet to connect, encourage, empower, and inspire each other. We also wanted to showcase the valiant efforts that South Street and Front Porch are making here in the community in the South Akron and Summit Lake area. So wanted to meet here and get people familiar with the Front Porch. So like I said, we connect, encourage, empower, and inspire each other. And we do that by connecting like-minded business professionals who share similar core values, struggles, and a personal calling to grow personally and professionally. We also encourage each other we focus on encouraging a building of our community through servant leadership while empowering each other to become effective, productive, and profitable business individuals while blending together our faith and good business practices. And then lastly, we inspire each other by coming here once a month and listening to compelling presentations by like-minded individuals and community leaders in our city. So like I said, we meet here once a month, the first Tuesday of every month, and I just wanted to, I have a couple of announcements, and I think Pam has one as well. There are a few events coming up. One, you'll see a few different flyers on your table. One is Trails and Rails, which is through South Street Ministries. It's their big fundraiser that they have each year. It is September 12th, so you can see if there's a flyer on your table for that. And next is the Connect to Akron event, which connects young professionals to nonprofits in the Akron area. So if you are a young professional or if you know any young professionals who might be interested in it, it's a great opportunity for them to get familiar with some of the nonprofits that are in the city of Akron. Just for example, they do like new board shadowing, or if you're really good at marketing, they need help with marketing or social media, they'll kind of tell you what they need help with, and you can volunteer. Next is the Halloween Charity Ball, which is a great fun event. Karen Starr, Roxy Moron, is actually playing the event, their band, so that'll be fun. And that's October 30th at 8 p.m. at Tangier. And this year they're donating all of the funds to Life is Good No Matter What. It's an adult make-a-wish program. So it's a lot of fun. It's a wide range of people, anywhere from the young professionals to Father Norm goes, so it's a blast. It's just a lot of fun. And then, Pam, did you have something that you wanted to share?
Just a couple, working a little bit with Mark Horst through Love Akron and doing a Love Akron Connect. So we have morning breakfast, but I think we can introduce people for our upcoming large breakfast, which is September 29th, 7 to 8:30. If you've never attended this breakfast, you may want to try it out. How many people want 250? I love it. Great way to start your morning, you need to give away Brenda.
Sort of leadership.
Also, I have these. I did not pass them out for the Renew lunch. That's a monthly lunch. And this one's extra special for September 10th. Our CEO, Dan Cummings, so let me know if you want any of those. I have them on. Thanks.
Yeah, does anyone else have any events or announcements that they would like to share?
September 9th at Greystone Hall at lunch, Lynn Richards, who's the CEO of Congresspreneur Business, CMU, she's going to come in and talk about some of her experiences in other cities similar to Akron. She also has in addition to her new urbanism model, and to give you a quick synopsis, new urbanism is kind of the physical form that a good place takes going forward in a city environment post-urban renewal, if that makes sense to you. If not, ask me later, I'll have more information. But she's going to speak about that, our inner belt, our combined sewer overflow project, so that'll be the 9th, so coming up quickly, that's one day after the primary election. So that'll be September 9th at noon at Greystone. All are welcome. Get ahead in advance.
Great.
Our press release on Monday, September 7th.
Okay. And then John Lopez will be
following.
Right, okay.
He'll be roundtable 2 weeks after.
That's after roundtable, yes, okay.
Also from the Congress.
All right, thanks. Anyone else have any birthdays or anything? So I just wanted to give you a little background about the organization. GAINS is a local gathering of sustainability practitioners who focus on advancing innovative ideas and sustainable values and practices in the marketplace. The salon-style meetings are free and interactive and open to anyone interested in learning about and engaging with community partners on the leading edge of sustainability. The goal of GAINS is to build awareness and demand, stimulate the economy, create jobs, and educate business professionals and consumers on sustainability for our community. GAINS has been promoting sustainability in Akron since 2012. And I have Gina Burke here from Exit Communications, which is a marketing communications and sustainability coaching business. And then Karen Starr, who owns Hazel Tree Interiors over on West Market Street in West Hill. So let's give them a round of applause.
Laughed when Kaylee said the organization GAINS because we're not a 501c3. We are a group of volunteers that got started with when Entrepreneurs for Sustainability disbanded in 2002. So to give you a little background on how it all began, E4S, Entrepreneurs for Sustainability, was a Cleveland-based organization that had been going for about 10 years, and there were a small handful of us, there were 8 of us that were really active in that organization that had a couple of Akron branches kind of over the years. When E4S disbanded, we kind of went, well, what are we going to do now? Because we've really enjoyed having this monthly touch point of a place to gather and throw out ideas and talk about, you know, our challenges and our opportunities and, you know, what's going on in the local government and the climate and all of that kind of stuff. So we got together and the 8 of us were Gina and myself and Tom Crane, who is known as the Going Green guy often, Tony Trophy, local developer, Philip Neighbors, who is co-owner of Mustard Seed Market, Sue Lacey from Round River Consulting, and Sabrina Schweier and Samuel Salisbury from Salisbury Schweier Sustainable Landscapers. Okay, got everybody? Yeah, so that was the core group that started this network, I guess. And we just initially reached out to all of our contacts and said, you know, you are having the same kind of conversations we are. We're going to start our own Akron-based meetings, and Tony Trophy let us use Musica and has let us use Musica or Uncorked ever since. Philip Neighbors with Mustard Seed has provided food ever since. And it's just kind of a monthly thing that we do on the second Wednesday of every month. The doors open at 5:30 and the conversation begins at 6:15. And we talk about, all sorts of different topics, that are under the umbrella of that word, sustainability. I jotted down just a few to kind of give you an idea of past topics over the years. We've done quite a few different conversations here and there on urban planning and placemaking. We've had Preservation Alliance of Greater Akron talk. We've had East Akron Neighborhood Development Corporation talk. Tony Trophy has talked about what he's got going down in downtown. We've talked about local foods, everything from community gardens and organizations that we're starting up to help those pop up more around the city. We've had a local foods month where we talked about education. alternative energy, alternative transportation, and Jason Segedy from Amiscom and talk, and had times where city managers have come, when Paula Davis from Quebec Beautiful was still Quebec Beautiful, she came and spoke, members of the planning department spoke, and it's just a really great interactive evening because, you know, we invite people to talk about a specific topic each month, but then the group is really engaged, so we always have a question and answer session at the end, and there's so much that happens, and a lot of progress is made, and I think that one of the most valuable things that has happened over time is bit by bit, we've really engaged a lot of government officials that have you know, really started to be engaged with our group and have many more conversations about, you know, what's needed and what's possible and who the resources are, people-wise, out in the community. So that's an overview of who we are and how we got started. Now the planning group is larger than when we first started. We have some other, you know, newer minds and people engaged with our core planning group. And that group meets once a month to talk about, you know, how we're doing with the next month and, you know, 6 months down the road and all of that. So yeah, that's what Gaines is. Gina, you want to add to this?
I want to ask the question of the group. Should I be using the mic? Would be helpful. I'd like to ask the group, what is sustainability to you? Have you heard of it? Dan, help me out.
Continuous undergirded.
Okay, continuous undergirded.
I'd say there's a blanket word for renewable energy or recycling. Or,
so it's a broad umbrella?
Yeah, I give it a broad.
Right. Yeah. So. Anybody kind of sustainability teams or green teams at their work?
We have LEED certified project managers.
LEED certified project managers, and what kind of business are you in?
We have a commercial construction company.
Commercial construction, excellent. Yes. Anyone else? Congress for New Urbanism is a core of sustainability. I'll explain that real quick, but anyone else? What kind of businesses are you in? Give me an idea.
Accounting.
Okay, accounting firms.
We're involved. We're the Greater Akron Chamber.
Greater
Akron. Some involvement.
Greater Akron Chamber. Okay. Anyone else? Give me an idea. Insurance company back there, I know that. What's that? Pay Street nonprofit. Okay, so the question is, why does sustainability matter to you? It's really a way broader, difficult question to answer than what we have here this morning that will keep you awake, since you do need to want to work. But we would like to inspire you to understand that sustainability should be the first question that is asked of any organization or business that started, but then those that exist need to ask the question, how would it impact our organization? It's called a budget, and it's called savings for an organization. And there are terms in sustainability that talk about low-hanging fruit. So the understanding of energy use, what the, you know, single easiest way to think about sustainability in an organization is to think about your monthly energy bill and how much is being spent there and what you could do to lower that cost in order to use resources and put them somewhere else. So it's not a redistribution of resources, it's a reallocation of them. And what are we going to, how will we do that? Making those choices. So sustainability will have three impacts. community, environmental, and economic impact. So it's called triple bottom line, business balance sheet, basically. And there are businesses today that are for-benefit businesses that have the accounting structure to actually show that metric, which is something that didn't exist 5 years ago, but it does exist today. So sustainability is often called the new modernism, which is a movement in art that reflects back with our Gaines Group. One of the reasons why we call it a salon is because we're trying to affect culture. Very simply, during all the big movements in the past, in the Industrial Age and the Artist Age, think about the Impressionist period back in France. There was something called salons that happened, and it was called the Beau Temps, which is the beautiful time. And basically, artists and scientists and people who were innovative and creative just met on a regular basis, and they would share their ideas, and they would create a new world. And that's why we have a salon, because it's all about coming and sharing your ideas and learning about what sustainability is. I personally have had the privilege of being involved in the startup of many initiatives in sustainability, as I was very much involved in E4S in Cleveland. But prior to that, I was also as a student in a master's program at Case Western Reserve University. Our focus was on sustainability, and you know, it was the Wild West of education. There's, you know, there just now are degree programs in sustainability, but we were defining it. My program is the organizational development program, but the Businessization of World Benefit is a large congress now of leading businesses in the world that make sustainability their number one focus. The Sustainability Index outperforms Wall Street on a regular basis by 5 to 7% annually. So there is something to be said for sustainability to be a driver of innovation. So that being said, one of the focuses we have with Gaines is to focus on our local economy and to look at the supply chain of businesses and find ways for building in the culture an entrepreneurial mindset. Fast Company just recently came out with a list of what makes cities successful. And the number one criteria is not that you have incubators, it's not that you have education, it is that you have an entrepreneurial mindset. And what does that look like? Well, that looks like a culture that we have been strongly building with Gaines, in that creative people, science, technical people, business people, people who are government-oriented, whatever, all cross-sections of society come together and they talk about how do we do this. Cleveland, through this, you know, organization and the context that I, you know, my business in Cleveland, Case Western Reserve started a process where they called the city together and said, how are we going to go forward? How will Cleveland sustain itself in the future? They created a vision that said we will be the greenest city on the bluest lake, because in 1969 the river burned, and that's a really negative impact from an environmental standpoint and a negative image. So they said by the year 2019 we want to be known as the greenest city on the bluest lake. And how are we going to get there? So started something called Sustainable Cleveland 2019, and which is every single year thousands of people come together in a congress and they talk about how they will make a sustainable impact in their area. So go online, look at sustainablecleveland.org, and just see the energy and the impact that has had. Cleveland has now put itself on the map as one of the most sustainable cities in the country. I think it's it's always in the top 10, which is a national ranking that matters, because cities that are viewed as the most sustainable, they actually are, attract people to them to want to live there. The number one criteria for millennials is to live in a city where sustainability matters. That's why they live in Portland. That's why they live in Chicago.